Let's see how Gmail uses various visual elements to help with grouping functional elements. So first of all, let's look at the whole Gmail window. And you notice here, instantly, there's large areas of different background color. So some sections of the screen have a white background, but there are two big areas that have a gray background. One is the search box at the top, but the other is the message area. So obviously within Gmail, why are you using Gmail? It's about email messages. And so the email messages as an area have been given a strong color coding in order that your eye instantly knows that's separate from all of the other things around it. So that's one major difference, and background color is being used to give that functional separation between the messages and the rest of the functionality of the page. What I'm going to do now is though is zoom in to the left-hand side where you have a number of elements. Some of it's about folders and tags, some of it's about messaging. So let's look at that left-hand side. So let's zoom into it. Here, the page has got various elements. It's got buttons to compose new messages, but also it's got a list of folders or tags, depending how you think about them. And it also, so icons and names that are to do with starting a meeting and joining a meeting, and then below that about Hangouts. Crucially for these, it's spacing. These are functional groups, but they're very clearly delineated, partly through space. Interestingly enough, I think maybe if that word meet had been a long word, they might have needed to add additional space in order to help it separate. It might be sufficient that it doesn't have an icon, but certainly it's fairly clear that there's functional differences. However, partly that's done by spacing and by things that are similar, that look similar. You can clearly see they fall into each other. But in addition, I'd like to point out that they're light grey lines, so it's in addition using lines, both to separate those functional groups on the left-hand side, but also between each mail message, because they go all the way along in a table. And that's a common story. In one sense, those lines are unnecessary. You can see where one group ends, functional group ends, the next start. You can, because mostly the mail messages have a long enough subject line, you don't have a big gap. You can see the line, the mail message, but the grey line just helps. And particularly if you have any sort of perceptual problems, or if you're just acting quickly and stressed, anything that can just help you. They've been done very light, so they're not making a lot of visual intrusion, they're not noisy, but they also can help you along the way. So here's a good example of ways you can be subtle about the use of grouping elements, but also very clear.